Your beggary is done, Tarben, and our feasting table will be warmer for it.
Eivor, that is kind of you. I hope one day I can repay you.
You are among friends here. There is no need.
No need, but a desire. An earnest one. I remember the good things people do for me. To warm my heart in times when kindnesses are few and far between. There was one more thing, though. If you had a moment, a grain merchant has set up downriver. I want to bring a half dozen bags home, but I would need an extra pair of hands.
I can lend a hand.
That's a relief. I did not fancy asking Holger.
Tarben, what brought you to our clan?
Your reputation. Heard folks say a band of hard-drinking, battle-scarred warriors had washed up on shore. Said you had settled in the center of Mercia, taking in whatever flotsam, jetsam, and jumble of misfits came to your docks.
And this appealed to you?
More than anything. Always been a bit of a drifter. The thought of settling in a rowdy camp felt like a good balance. And being a baker, I knew my services would not be sniffed at.
I did not take you for a baker when we met. You have the look of someone who swings an axe.
I do hear that a lot.
But baking is your only craft, is that right?
I have always enjoyed it. And I have always been good at it. But when I'm not able to find such work, I take odd jobs where I can. So long as I can work with my hands.
Well, we have that in common.
Question, Eivor. You're a warrior, a fighter. That much I know. But if you could stop fighting, what would you do?
You ask the wrong question. I can stop fighting. But to do so would be to deny the essence of who I am. I think you mean, if I had to stop fighting, what would I become?
No, you've given me the answer I wanted. It's good you've found what calls you. A rare and happy thing.
Yes, yes, I see you both. What can I... It's you. What are you doing in Mercia?
Collecting grain. 30 silver's worth, if you can spare it. I do have the coin.
Right. Well... Take what you need and get going.
That should cover it. Thank you kindly.
Of course. And you, you take good care of yourself. Yeah?
Nissen forgive this and get cheeks on now. Hey, it's my blood fight.
Is that your usual vendor? He seemed a little surprised to see you.
Did he? Well, could be he knows somebody who looks like me. There's no shortage of big bearded men around here, yeah?
I suppose not. About your question earlier, what would I do if I weren't a warrior? I would ask the same of you. Is baking bread your greatest wish?
Is there something wrong with wanting to bake bread? The Romans baked bread. The Egyptians baked bread.
It is a fine trait. But is it your calling?
It is my calling to feed people, I'd say. To be of service to those I care for. And who care for me. That brings me joy.
Put that way, it is a noble pursuit.
I don't know that it's noble. It is simply what gets me up in the morning. It gives me purpose for the rest of my day.
Need help with your grain?
No need, no need. I'll do the rest myself. Bring it in and put it where I like.
All right. It was good to speak with you, Torben. A welcome diversion.
You too, Eivor. Thank you for your help.
If it is strength you require, you need look no further.
Join your blade to mine. Let ring the sword song this day.
Thank you.
To the Swan Road. You must row in these waters. Let's have a song. Among you.
We all remember when Eivor gave orders to attack Kjotve's clan in Avaldsnes. I knew even then our chance at victory was slim. It was a fool's errand. But Eivor demanded we strike, and I am not one to disobey my superior. Such is the mark of an honorable man. You all know what followed. We set upon Kjotve's men and were overwhelmed. You lot were captured and fit to be butchered. Here, carried off to be sold into slavery, a fate worse than a fine death. But there is one fact you do not know. In the initial fight, I came upon Kjotve. Cowering in an empty house. He did not see me, and I came within 2 arms' lengths of him. I could have slain him! A fast stroke of my axe, ending our troubles. But I held back. Why? Because I remembered my oath to Eivor. Yes, years ago, Eivor had staked a claim on Kjotve's life. So I left the Bakraut alone. Yes.
A pity, Dag. There is no one living who can verify this incredible tale.
You coward! I want to talk to you.
We keep our wits about us.
Can't hold out much longer.
Man your oars. continue later.
Bound to be rich.
The blood soul.
Let's go, Whitecage.
By all the saints. Split you!
blow! take you!
Come, brother. Let's end this.
Going to smash you!
Even little hits take a toll. Do this alone!
Thank you.
Need to roll.
Sail!
Catch the wind!
In the early days of the feud between Kiotve the Cruel and the Raven Clan, there was a mad berserker called Kiar Robo. Kiar had pledged his battle fury to no king or jarl, and would give his oath only once each winter, for reasons nobody could fathom. One year, Kiar's sister Thura was married to Kiotve's brother Alrek, and soon Kiar was often seen in the company of that clan. But soon after, word came to Kiar.
Hush now. Run up the sail!
Keep Silver there!
Are you at the good part yet? Take the
master.
Fortifications there, Eivor.
Oh!
Eivor! Probably hostile!
Salutations!
Have you got a contract for me?
I have requests that may or may not involve violence. Interested? Odds are, the target is dead. But, no hurry. But sooner's always better for the target.
I must take my leave. So long.
Coming after, Stiermaier.
We're off. No raising the sail here.
Dock the ship here! Sing us a song! Off we go.
Can't raise the sail yet.
Strike of the tune. Let the sail out! Let's have a song. We'll share a tale.
Some years ago, I took the sea with a sword dancer called Eyin. A brooding warrior with a face of stone and oak-hard arms. On a raid in Courland, we shored up along the edge of a forest and explored until we came to People Parks, a large farm. It was night, and all were asleep. So we set about plundering the place in the quiet of eve, taking sheep and goats as we pleased.
We'll pick up from there.
A priest's treasury! Look! One of their rich temples!
Where were you?
It was night, and all were asleep. So we set about plundering the place in the quiet of eve, taking sheep and goats as we pleased. It was then that Eyin saw a farmhand pressing the boy for the family's hidden silver. The farmhand screamed like a crow. He hid beneath an anvil at the smith's forge, and the silver was no trouble to lift. In secret, we took it and the boy back to the ship. It was then that Eyin grew sad. When the farmers woke, with the crack of day, they would know they had been robbed. Not by whom.
More sails!
So Eyin ordered three of us to follow him back to the sleep-hushed hamlet. As we burnt the houses, Eyin shouted his name.
I am Eyin, son of Skatlagrim, and I am the man who deprives you of everything but your life. I never sailed with Eyin again.
Sing, my ravens. You Salskjall's got a story.
Here is a story I have not told a man, for it happened only last month. I was sharing a mead horn with a beautiful woman. When she...
Bring the mask down!
And her mother all begged for your hand in marriage. Is that how this tale ends?
Yes. Were you...
Set the mask up!
Were you there?
Run out of the sail! Let's hear a story.
When I was 11 winters old, I was the youngest of my favorite cousins. Wild and rowdy bunch of boys and girls. Together with our parents, we attended a feast at the home of Halfdan the Black of the House of Yngling. To toughen our patience, our parents set us with the old woman, who ordered us to bake flatbreads and serve it to the noble. After an hour, the flatbreads piled so high into pillars, you could have built a roof over it and called it a longhouse. When our work was done, an older boy, Uthrod, suggested we steal a keg of mead and drown in happiness for our good work. So Uthrod, Mikkel and Åsa snuck into the storeroom and stole a barrel as I stood watch. But when we were spotted, I froze.
Save it for later.
We will attack on sight here.
Of Harald's men stopped us. They struck Uthrod and Mikkel and pushed Åsa to the ground. Whose idea was this? They asked. I stood and said, the idea was mine. The mead is for me. One of the men eyed me and said only, that is not true. Then they moved on.
We'll pick up from there.
There lieth still more remnants of the Nephilim. I have marked a symbol upon the stones, that future folk may imbue their spirit with the energy within. For those who wish to seek communion with the Lord here, be wary, for he speaks through ciphers, and his words are woven with ancient fibers. He is manifest here. He hath made importance of these pillars wrought by the giants of yore, now guarding us, as only he knows. Amen.
Show me.
Hey!
Yubs.
Your time in Midgard is over now. Crossing a new threshold, take care, for it is difficult to know what foes lie in wait beyond. Need to row our way up.
Sail! Catch the wind! We need an epic tale.
Some time ago, I met a wandering skald in search of a jarl or king to serve. He had not composed a verse in years, and was fearful of losing his skill. I said I knew...
Hold on, good skald. Where you at the good part yet?
He had not composed a verse in years, and was fearful of losing his skill. I said I knew many such great men.
We can continue later.
Ripe for plunder!
By name, but to my knowledge, all of them had many skalds of their own. This poor skald was disappointed and thanked me for my time, asking my name as he departed. Dognithison, I told him. The skald's eyes went wide. Dognithison, he exclaimed. Of Thornburg? I nodded and said, the very man I am.
Save it for later.
Regret the choices that led you here in the afterlife.
Well, in Hall of Kings.
Martian speed.
Look! Some sort of port there!
Continue later.
Hearken well in Hall of Kings. On ocean speed, my words gain wings. Oh, things meet, I forth will bring. For noble deeds.
Save it for later. Hush now.
spoken well in Hall of Kings.
Thank you.